All right, everyone. In this video, we're going to discuss the few steps needed to take to get you up and running with CoPilot. Now, there's going to be two prerequisites that we'll need to complete before we entertain this endeavor. One is to have VS Code, the application, already set up on your local machine, and two, to have already created a GitHub account. Now, once we have created that GitHub account, effectively, the next step we need to do is associate that account as a student. And so how we're going to do that is we're going to navigate to this URL, education.github.com, in which there's a student developer pack option. Now, effectively, what the student developer pack is essentially to provide students with free access to a variety of developer tools and services. The one in which we are most interested in is the CoPilot option, but of course that's going to be bundled across a few other plugins and features. And so how we're going to do that is we're going to apply as an individual student, and as the URL shows, it arrives you to an application process. Of course, there's going to be some qualifications, of which I believe most people watching this video will already hit. And then you'll be asked a few questions, and you'll click through the prompts, and then eventually submit your application. Now, it took about a week, but eventually GitHub Education will send you, you know, a big heart and say, welcome to the global campus. And now, essentially, you can understand this as your GitHub account is now flagged as a student, and then you get all student-like features. That's awesome, right? So now we can go more on the VS Code side. So in VS Code, you're going to want to do two things. One, to have logged in as yourself, your account through your VS Code. And that can be done through different extensions. One is the GitHub pull request and issue. This is going to be the one that you're going to essentially use when you're pushing code up to a remote repository, if you're connected to an assignment. And so naturally you're going to have to log in to GitHub. And so, right, that's grand. So now you're in VS Code, you have a student account associated with your GitHub account, and you've logged into that account in your VS Code, right? So then the last step you need to do is just download and install GitHub Copilot. And this is the extension right here. It's exactly in the name, GitHub Copilot. And once you install, now that extension is on your local machine. The last step you'll need to perform, and this is the crux of the issue for most people, is that you need to authorize GitHub Copilot. And how that authorization will come through is through a notification. But default, if you're new to VS Code and you have Do Not Disturb mode enabled, you will never get that notification to activate or give access for GitHub Copilot. And so the solution there is just to scroll over to the lower right bar, and you'll be prompted a message most likely, and you would just need to authorize. And then once you have done that, you are all set up. And then you can do little stuff like this, like make comment, print, I did it, off to become, let's see what Copilot says, a data scientist for I, let's see if it can finish it, there it is, tab, run it, boom. All right, hope this was helpful. Bye, y'all.